This video will take you through steps 3 and 4 of the onboarding process. The first is the sender tab. This information is used wherever you manage an order where you want to create a label for. To avoid having to enter that information for every order every time, you can simply fill it out once in this section and it will be populated for every order automatically. The same applies with the shipment defaults. The shipment default is a setting that helps you autofill information instead of repeating that step every time. You can select, for example, a standard service that you want to use. You can set up and define your default package sizes, which would be applied to every order. In the My Package section, you can set up your package sizes here and then you can pre-select them in the Orders section when you create a label. UPS requires certain information to always be filled in. The Receiver defaults allows you to provide a phone number so your labels are not missing any required information. The Fulfillment section enables you to update the fulfillment information to the Commerce system as soon as a label is created. Updating the information to Shopify means sending a tracking number and a tracking URL to the respective order. It is advised to set this option to yes, so you do not have to do it manually for every order. The Notification section is a feature to inform the buyer as soon as the package has been shipped or delivered, or an exception is set. You can configure those settings by default. For example, if you would like for the buyer email to always be notified on every order. You can also add other people to the notifications. For example, if you as a seller would like to be notified, you can add your email here. The next section is the label format. Here, all the label formats that UPS offers are available. You can also set some defaults for commercial invoices. For example, the unit of measurement. The country of origin is usually taken from Shopify since it populates this information. In case this is not set up on your Shopify store, here you can define the country of origin. The same applies for additional services. You can enable those so that every time you are creating an order, these default settings will be selected. Here is an example of additional services being selected. If you then go to the Orders section, then create a label by clicking on the Actions button, then selecting Create a Shipping Label, you will find that the shipment defaults are now pre-populated. The sender information is filled in and does not have to be entered again. The receiver information comes directly from Shopify. The service selected as a shipment default is also pre-populated. The package dimensions and weight are already pre-populated. You will also find that the other additional services like delivery confirmation and the DDP options selected as shipment defaults are also already set up automatically as part of the default configuration. As soon as you have your sender information and shipment defaults configured, you are ready to start printing labels in an easy and streamlined way.